Alright, I know I made a lot of videos already today, but this one is very important and it is pertaining to my apricot trees. I have two apricot trees now. Originally there was one apricot tree all by himself or herself and peach trees nearby, but no other apricot tree. This particular tree has been growing, it's quite healthy, it's waving around with its leaves in the wind, you know, it's just kind of that type. And then today, yesterday, I brought it, another apricot tree into the garden, okay? And I am like, what is the deal? I put this tree, it is a moorland apricot dwarf. I put it in like the patio area, just maybe 15 feet from the original one. The one that has been planted is just like losing its mind. It is waving, like, hello, look at me, look at me. I am not kidding. The other trees were not doing it. The other trees were just like, no big deal, we got another tree nearby. But the apricot, the one that has been there in the soil, is just gaga, googa, gaga in love over the new, dwarf apricot tree. Now, the dwarf apricot tree is not responding though. It is not making the same response. It's just kind of blasé. You know, it just got here, it's got here from the store. But the one that is in the soil is like, look at me, I'm in love with you. You know, it's like that's what it's trying to say. So it's becoming like this already a tragic love affair that isn't happening. It's becoming a Greek tragedy. This apricot tree, it just is just going bonkers. Like, I adore. I am just, it's like my dreams, my wishes, they've all come true, you know. It's that type of fanatical love. It's that type that is just like, you could call it the fan, you can call it that type that is just, you cannot, it's just naive, there's nothing jaded. It is just like, you know, I expect you there, near me. And now, I'm like, well, I didn't have plans, you know, I didn't have plans to put the dwarf near, like right next to this other. And the other is not acting the same, like it needs it. So, I mean, is this just a situation where it's going to be a jilted love? Is this tree now going to be in this, like, well, you know, I called out, I said who I am, I said how I feel. And so what now is going to happen to my original apricot tree if he is not reciprocated? So now if I plant, so this is just becoming a major disruption. So if I plant the new dwarf, it's a moorland, I believe. If I plant it around the corner, which is what I had intended, you know, to just épalier along the house, it's not even in eyesight any longer. It's not an eye view vision of the original one that is saying, hey, you know, hello. Well, it's not envisioned. So then I'm going to be like this terrible person that put the tree around the corner and to stop love from happening. And yet I'm like, well, what if the dwarf one doesn't want it? You know, what if this is just a situation, a love tragedy moment? The dwarf is just like, really don't care about that one. It's just too like emotionally aggressive and wanting. And, you know, maybe it's just too young in their head, and they just have got to calm down about the want for love. So maybe it's just an immature, you know, and maybe my new the Moreland dwarf is what do we call it? Older and not requiring that guppy love. Oh my gosh. And if I do put them closer now, this, you have no idea how terrible this is. If I put the new dwarf closer to the other. Now, is that fair to the dwarf Moreland? Is that fair? Because it's just like, what did you put me there for? It's just going to be pawning me all the time, just pawning all over me, you know, just slathering me with adorness. And I don't want to be slathered with adorness, like I adore you all the time. You know, I mean, I just wanted to just, you know, be contemplative more. So I am seeing here, I'm witnessing the relationship of love that is not reciprocated, you know, as the same with the trees. And so it's very, very interesting and intriguing to me. I just love the garden itself. The gardens that are such alive. If you're open to their intentions, you will find that, what is the deal with the trees? I mean, are they like people? I swear they're like people. They have minds in there, and love is existing. The aspect of it, the entire gamut of love is capable. Meanwhile, this morning afternoon, I planted a Santa Rosa plum. And I'm in my head, I'm in my think thoughts, I'm bad because it's distance from the other plum, it's over 50 feet. Apparently within 50 feet is an okay range for pollination. And they say these are kind of self-pollinating anyway. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm just feeling bad, you know, because the bee himself has to journey so far and to make like extra plums. And so I'm feeling this in my head, like for hours, you know, the strife that I'm giving the bee. And so here I am, and I'm planting it away, and then it's there, it's done. And I finally finish, and I've watered it in, and I'm standing there. So a second tree I planted that today. And lo and behold, this black bee, a huge black bee, just goes, does a buzz right by me, like zzz, like he knows it's there. He knows he has to go past the 50 feet, and he's like in a, what do we call that, a like mind with me, because I was thinking about him, and then there he is, you know. So he's a privy. He's privy to the tree and the issue of this tree and that tree being such a great grand distance. And he's just like, not bothered. Just like, just blow it off. Just blow it off. It's okay, you know. And off he goes. You know, he really did like a looped around the tree halfway and then went. So I don't know. I mean, when we talk about intelligence, you know, intelligence, it's just there. It's just there in nature, before humans. It's just there. All right.